So friends, today we are going to see about the TB or tuberculosis. And here we will see about the general introduction about tuberculosis or TB, then about that causative agent, which is called as the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then we will see about how that disease gets spread or transmitted. Then symptoms we will see, diagnosis we will see here, and prevention, okay? So these different parameters we are going to see under this heading or in this tuberculosis disease. So that tuberculosis, we know that it is a bacterial disease, okay? Tuberculosis, it is a bacterial disease, and it is a disease of respiratory system, okay? So this TB or tuberculosis, it is a potentially fatal, contagious disease which can affect almost any part of the body. So though it is related, or though we can call it as a respiratory disease, but it can occur in kidneys also, in spinal cord also, or in brain also. So it is, it can affect the almost any part of the body, but it is the mainly infection of the lungs or of the respiratory system. So in Latin word, that tubercle, meaning round or round nodules, or there is a swelling is there. And oasis means that is a condition. So that is the swelling condition we can see here, and that is called as the tuberculosis. Okay. Then this is about the causative organism. So the causative organism or causative agent of this tuberculosis is a bacterium, which is known as the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. And this Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it is a acid fast bacteria. The main characteristic or identity of this acid fast bacteria is, that means this bacteria, they have the higher percentage of specific acid, fatty acid in their cell wall, and that is called as mycolic acid. Okay, so this infection, that is by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it is occur in the human being, and the infection from that Mycobacterium bovis, this is the another species of that Mycobacterium, and that causes the infection in the animals. So these are the causative organisms of that tuberculosis here, or Mycobacterium. And there are some other causative organisms are there, which are included in this Mycobacterium. And that includes Mycobacterium africanum, then Mycobacterium microti, then non-Mycobacterium species are also there. That includes Mycobacterium lepri, then Mycobacterium avium, and Mycobacterium asiaticum, okay? And this complex organism, that is the Mycobacterium tuberculosis complex, that includes these different types of species of Mycobacterium. For example, Mycobacterium africanum, Mycobacterium bovis, Mycobacterium caneti, and Mycobacterium microti. So these are the different species here. So what are the characteristics of this bacteria here, which is a causative agent of the TB or tuberculosis? So the name of that bacteria is Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and these Mycobacterium tuberculosis, these are gram-positive bacteria, then these are obligate aerobic in nature, then these are non-spore formers, that means they does not produce endospores, these are non-motile, that is they cannot move from one location to another location, then mesophilic organism, then the diameter or the size of that bacteria is 0.2 to 0.6 into 2 to 4 micrometer. Then these are, they have this slow generation time, that is 15 to 20 hours. Generation time means here, that is the time which is required to double the that population. Suppose, for example, here, if initially there is one bacteria is there, and to produce or to become a double that population, that means two. So, whatever the time is required, that time is called as the generation time. And in case of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, the generation time is, it is very large, and that is 15 to 20 hours. That means 15 to 20 hours are required to become two cells, two Mycobacterium tuberculosis cells from one Mycobacterium tuberculosis cell. Or वही अगर हम generation time E. coli के बारे में देखेंगे, तो it is only 20 minutes. मतलब 20 मिनट्स में ई कोलाई के एक बैक्टीरिया के वहां पे दो बैक्टीरिया हो जाते हैं. सो दैट इज डिफरेंट. सो एंड मे कंट्रीब्यूट टू द वायरुलेंस आल्सो. so that lipid rich cell wall. Abhi just few in previous slides I told here that Mycobacterium tuberculosis, they have the special type of fatty acid or lipid that is called as the mycolic acid. Okay, and this lipid rich cell wall, which consists of this mycolic acid, that is means, and the 50% of cell wall, it is the dry weight. Then that is responsible for many of these bacterial special characteristics properties. So whatever that special characteristics are present here, so that are due to the that pathogens, that mycolic acid. Then these are acid fast. So that means they retain the acidic stains and they confers the resistance to the detergents as well as antibacterials. So how that Mycobacterium tuberculosis, that lung infection, or which is called as the TB, can be classified. So that tuberculosis or TB, it is classified into two types. One is the pulmonary tuberculosis or pulmonary TB, we can say here. And that is the primary disease and secondary disease. So that pulmonary tuberculosis, that means it is related to the lungs or limited to the lungs. And after that, extra pulmonary, that means just we have seen in definition. So though that infection, it is primarily the inward organ is lungs, but that infection can be spread to the different parts of the body. So when that infection is causing to the different parts of the body, except or besides these lungs, if it is occurring in the lungs, then it is called as pulmonary tuberculosis. And if it is in the other organs of the body or parts of the body, then that is called as extra pulmonary. And examples include here, for example, lymph node tuberculosis, pleural tuberculosis, then TB of the upper airways, skeletal tuberculosis, genitourinary tuberculosis, then miliary tuberculosis, pericardial tuberculosis, gastrointestinal tuberculosis, then tuberculosis of meninges. And so these are the different organs involved in the infection by that tuberculosis. And when other organs are involved, then it is called as extra pulmonary tuberculosis. Okay, so this is the how that throughout the world that TB is spread here. Then so in 2011, there were an estimated 8.7 million incidence cases of TB globally, so throughout the world. And in 2011, so that population which was infected with tuberculosis bacterium, and that persons who are suffering from tuberculosis, that was 8.7 million. Okay, and it is equivalent to 125 cases in 1 lakh population. Okay, so that means in 1 lakh population, how many pupils or that persons are suffering? 125. So in that is in 2011. And among that Asian population which was suffering from tuberculosis, that was 59%. African population was 26%. Then Eastern Mediterranean region 7.7%, European region 4.3%, and regions of the America, that is 3%. So that was the total population which was infected in 2011. So this is the new tuberculosis cases, that is 22 high burden countries or HBCs in 2020. So these are the cases in India, then China, South Africa, Indonesia, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Philippines. So that is, we can say in the Asia that more cases were there. Okay, then Ethiopia, Nigeria. So in this way, Cambodia. So these are the cases in 2011, that of the tuberculosis or TB. And that India is the highest TB burden country, according for more than 1/5 of the global incidence. See here, these are the total cases in throughout the world here. And this red portion, that is the cases of tuberculosis in India, 21%. Then other countries, 20, that is in China, 14%, Indonesia, 6%, Nigeria, 5%, South Africa, 5%, Bangladesh, 5%, then this Ethiopia, 3%, Pakistan, 3%, Philippines, 3%, then other 13 countries here, 16%, and other countries, 20%. But in alone in India, that population or that patients who are suffering from TB, that was 21% population here. Okay, this is the incidence of tuberculosis here. Number of deaths, for example, here, that is tuberculosis 700. Then HIV deaths here, measles, sexually transmitted diseases, malaria, and other particular diseases here. Okay, and this is the age group. So that pupils which are involved, for example, 55 and more than 55 age persons, that was this one, this highest per population here. Then 35 to 54, this one, 15 to 34, this one, and 5 to 14 aged population, that was up to this year. So in this way, and now next point, we will see how that spread of tuberculosis takes place, or how that TB gets spread from the, or transmitted from diseased person to the healthy person. Okay, so this is the healthy diseased person here who is suffering from the TB and coughing without covering to the mouth. So that can add pathogens because of in coughing or in sneezing, because this pathogen is present in the respiratory system mainly. And so it will comes outside the patient's body along with his sputum, along with his cough, or during sneezing like that. And therefore coughing or talking or sneezing without covering the mouth or nose, that can add pathogens or that Mycobacterium tuberculosis bacteria in the air. So crowded places with poor ventilation, then spitting everywhere. So these are some reasons why that TB getting, or it is spreading, or it is transmitting. Okay. Then symptoms of the tuberculosis. So what are the symptoms here? It includes persistent cough. Persistent cough means if that cough is remain for longer duration or more than 1 month, for example. अगर एक महीने से ज्यादा कफिंग वहां पे हो रही है पर्टिकुलर पर्सन को ट्रीटमेंट लेने के बाद भी, तो एक मतलब साइन वहां पे हो सकता है दैट कफिंग इट मे बी ड्यू टू द इन्फेक्शन ऑफ लंग्स फ्रॉम माइकोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरक्लोसिस. देन अनदर सिम्टम इज यर चेस्ट पेन. देन कफिंग विथ ब्लडी स्प्यूटम. इफ दैट स्प्यूटम ऑफ द पर्सन कंसिस्ट ऑफ ब्लड और ब्लडी स्प्यूटम इज देयर, देन दैट इज वन ऑफ द इंडिकेशन ऑफ द infection from Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then difficulty or shortness of breath, then urine discoloration, then cloudy and reddish urine, then fever with chills and fatigue. So all these are the common or severe symptoms in case if that person is infected with the Mycobacterium tuberculosis. See, based on the types of TB, that's there are different symptoms are there. For example, so these are the symptoms of tuberculosis. So here, established pulmonary tuberculosis. So that includes the productive cough. So cough will be there. Then in this way, so primary pulmonary tuberculosis. Then structural abnormalities will be there, that is in the lungs. Then return of dormant tuberculosis. So here, in case of lungs, that fever, weakness, then cough with increasing mucus, then coughing off of blood, then gastrointestinal symptoms. If that Mycobacterium tuberculosis infect the gastrointestinal system, then that symptoms include extra pulmonary here. So that is including gastrointestinal, then meninges, then later on lymph nodes, joint or bones. And that symptoms include here severe symptoms, we can say weight loss, fever, weakness, then dry cough. So these are the symptoms here. Okay, so this is about the symptoms. Then steps in the pathogenesis of tuberculosis. So which are the different steps, so or how that particular infection can spreads here. So that steps includes exposure to the source. Exposure to the source means here, ki if that particular person, one person is infected from tuberculosis or Mycobacterium tuberculosis, or if he is suffering from TB, then when he sneezes, coughs, or talks, so he will add the microorganisms or that pathogen in the air. So that person who is already suffering from the tuberculosis or TB, he is acting as a source of infection here. Okay, and when healthy person get exposed to such source, so at that time that is nothing but the acrosolization of the droplet nuclei. So that droplets which are coming from the patient after sneezing, coughing or talking, so that droplets consist of the that pathogen. Okay, and when such droplets are inhaled by the healthy person, okay, agar healthy person se ye droplets inhale ho gaye, to usme se 50% more than 50% cases mein to kuch infection nahi aata, kyunki that some people are healthy or some people have the high resistance power, or their resistance power is good, or immunity power is good. Okay, so that's why there is no infection. But that bacteria in some persons who inhaled that bacteria or that droplets, so that bacteria or that pathogen, it can reach to the lungs and they enters into the macrophages. Macrophages are the phagocytic cells of the lungs, we can see here. Okay, and generally this Mycobacterium tuberculosis, it has one important property, that means they can multiply in the macrophages. Actually what happens, there is a phagocytosis is there, engulfment of pathogens by phagocytic cells, but these bacteria that macrophages, that Mycobacterium tuberculosis, when they are entering into the phagocytic cells of the lungs, which are called as macrophages, so these Mycobacterium tuberculosis, they can multiply even in macrophages. That means that macrophages, they cannot engulf, but or they cannot degrade or kills that pathogen. So that pathogens, they get dominated in macrophages and they multiply there. Okay, and that granulomatous lesions can begins to form the necrosis or tissue damage wahan pe hota hai, and that tissue damage or necrosis, it results into the that causes the bacteria cease to grow, then lesions calcifies. Matlab wahan pe just there is a swelling will be there of calcification, then lesions liquefies, that lesions get damaged here or liquid get liquids, and that bacteria coughed up into the sputum, or that bacteria kya hote fir baad mein cough mein aa jate hai, and that can again spread that infection to the another person. From there, that bacteria which gets ceases to grow, and that calcified lesions, that immune suppression takes place, that immune system get deactivated or suppressed, and reactivation of that bacteria occur. So again, once that bacteria get reactivated here, after the suppression of immune system or resistance power, and again that bacteria get enter into the macrophages and they multiply there. So in this way, that infection from Mycobacterium tuberculosis increases. Okay, and here when that lesions gets liquefied, lesions of that Mycobacterium tuberculosis, at that time that bacteria enters into the blood or organs. So they spread to the blood, they spread to the different organs, and finally there is a death of that person or that patient takes place. So these are the different stages of the steps in the pathogenesis of tuberculosis. And pathogenesis ka matlab kya hai, that is the mechanism how that particular bacteria or pathogen can cause the infection or cause the disease. That means which different steps are involved in the disease development, that is called as pathogenesis. Then in detail we are going to see here, that is types of tuberculosis. So the first one is the pulmonary tuberculosis or pulmonary TB, and in that we are going to see here pulmonary, that means related to the lungs here. When that infection is in the lungs, then that TB is called as the pulmonary tuberculosis. Okay, so here one is the primary tuberculosis. So the infection of an, so what is meant by primary tuberculosis, so the infection of an individual who has not been previously infected or immunized, it is called as primary tuberculosis, or it is known as Ghosn's complex or childhood tuberculosis. Matlab agar us particular person agar pehli bar infected ho raha hai, ya fir pehli bar use infection ho raha hai ट्यूबरक्लोसिस से, तो उसे हम क्या कहेंगे, प्राइमरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस कहेंगे. जैसे कि हमने प्रीवियस लेक्चर में देखा था कि प्राइमरी इन्फेक्शन हम किसे कह रहे हैं, कि अगर पहली बार इन्फेक्शन हो रहा है, जैसे एक कोविड का एग्जांपल लिया था हमने नोवेल कोरोना वायरस का, कि अगर पहली बार उसे इन्फेक्शन हो रहा है तो उसे हम क्या कहेंगे, प्राइमरी इन्फेक्शन कहेंगे. ओके, एंड लेशंस, which are formed after the infection, that is in these are peripheral, and that can be accompanied by the blares or that lesions which are generally not detectable in the chest radiography. मतलब एक्सरे में इनिशियली कुछ वहां पे आपको नहीं दिखेगा, एक्सरे करने के बाद भी, चेस्ट एक्सरे करने के बाद भी. जो सेकंड टाइप है पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस, उसे हम कहेंगे सेकेंडरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस. सो व्हाट आर दिस सेकेंडरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस? द इन्फेक्शन दैट इंडिविजुअल हु हैज बीन प्रीवियसली इन्फेक्टेड और सेंसिटाइज्ड, इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेकेंडरी और पोस्ट प्राइमरी और री इन्फेक्शन और क्रोनिक ट्यूबरक्लोसिस. री इन्फेक्शन, री जैसे कि हमने कोविड का ही एग्जांपल लिया था, फिर से अगर वही इन्फेक्शन हो रहा है, जैसे कि लास्ट ईयर में हुआ था कि चलो एक बार कोविड से वो रिकवर हो गया, लेकिन कुछ एक दो महीने बाद उसे फिर से इन्फेक्शन हो गया, तो उसी को हम री इन्फेक्शन कहते हैं. तो सेकेंडरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस का मतलब क्या है कि दैट पर्सन हु इज प्रीवियसली इन्फेक्टेड और सेंसिटाइज, सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेकेंडरी इन्फेक्शन और पोस्ट प्राइमरी. पोस्ट मीन आफ्टर. प्राइमरी इन्फेक्शन के बाद अगर वहां पे सेम पैथोजन से इन्फेक्शन हो रहा है तो उसे हम कहेंगे पोस्ट प्राइमरी इन्फेक्शन, और उसी को हम कहेंगे री इन्फेक्शन, और दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द क्रोनिक इन्फेक्शन ट्यूबरक्लोसिस हियर. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट वन इज हियर, दैट इज एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी टीबी. सो दैट मीन्स एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी टीबी मीन्स हियर इन सो एक्सेप्ट इफ दैट पर्टिकुलर इन्फेक्शन by this mycobacterium tuberculosis is occurring in the different organs of the body, then it is called as extra pulmonary TB or tuberculosis. And that 20% of the patients of TB, they are affected that other body sites also. And one of extra pulmonary tuberculosis is that is lymph node TB, that is tuberculous lymphadenitis. उसी को हम क्या कहेंगे? Tuberculous lymphadenitis. Okay, so that is nothing but the infection of lymph node. Okay, and generally this is occur in the persons who are infected with HIV. Okay, so the symptoms includes painless swelling of the lymph nodes, and most commonly at the cervical and supraclavicular, that is in the bones or in cervical region. Okay, and this infection, it is limited to the patients who are infected with HIV or human immunodeficiency virus. Okay, so that is nothing but the lymph node tuberculosis here. Then pleural tuberculosis, so that involvement of the pleura, that is common in primary tuberculosis, and that is result from the penetration of this bacteria into the pleural space, that is in the stomach or that colon. So that space will be infected with this Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then next one is your symptoms, that is tuberculosis of the or TB of upper airways of the respiratory system, and that involves the that organs of the respiratory system, for example larynx, then pharynx and epiglottis. So these are the part of upper respiratory system. Okay, and symptoms include dysphagia, that means there is a swelling will be there, and chronic productive cough. So there is a that coughing will be for longer duration. Next one is here, that is genitourinary infection. Mm-hmm. Okay, that is in tuberculosis. Mm-hmm. Tuberculosis of the genitourinary system. Okay, so what is this genitourinary infection or tuberculosis here? So 15% of the all extra pulmonary cases, these are of genitourinary tuberculosis. Okay, or urinary system we can say here. And any part of the genitourinary target get infected. So that may be the that bladder, for example, like that here. Okay, then skeletal or bones. So involvement of the weight bearing parts, which for example spine, then hip or knee. So then this type of tuberculosis, it is called as skeletal tuberculosis, and symptoms include pain in the hip joints, then pain in the knees, as well as swelling of knees, and there is a trauma or fracturing will be there. Okay, so So that is called as the skeletal tuberculosis. Then gastrointestinal tuberculosis, that is related to the gastrointestine or digestive system. So there is an involvement of any part of the GI tract. GI stands for gastrointestinal tract. Okay. And that may be the stomach, that may be the intestine, large intestine, small intestine, then liver, for example, like that here. Symptoms include abdominal pain, diarrhea, and weight loss. So that is the gastrointestinal tuberculosis. The next one is here. The next one is here, that is TB of meninges or TB meningitis or and tuberculoma. Okay. So that 5% of all the extrapulmonary cases, these are related to the TB of meningitis. And that results from the hematogenous spread, that is to the blood of primary and secondary tuberculosis here. Then next one is the TB of pericarditis. So 1 to 8% of all extrapulmonary cases, these are related to this. The next one is here, miliary or disseminated TB. So it results from the hematogenous spread of tubercle bacillus, and it is spread due to the entry of infection into pulmonary vein or that lungs vein, and that lesions in different extrapulmonary sites or to the other parts of the body or to the organs. And another one is the less common, matlab that such type of TB which is a extrapulmonary also, but it is less common, and that includes the uveitis, then panophthalmitis, then painful hypersensitivity related factilinar conjunctivitis, that is related to the eyes. So that are less common or very rare. So these are the TBs which are nothing but the extrapulmonary tuberculosis. Now the next point we will see here, that is of diagnosis of the tuberculosis. So how there is a diagnosis can be done. So one is the bacteriological test, and that bacteriological test includes Gill-Nielsen's staining technique, that is the microscopic examination, and Auramin stain, that is fluorescence microscopy. So these two are the bacteriological tests that can be used to diagnose the tuberculosis. Then after that, there is a sputum culture test is there. Sputum culture in the sense here, that sputum is taken as a specimen or as a sample, and whether that pathogens are present in the sputum or not, that are identified by taking that sample or sputum sample here. That is called as the sputum culture test. And the nutrient media which are used here, that includes Lowenstein-Jensen solid medium, that requires 4 to 18 weeks, then liquid medium 8 to 14 weeks, agar medium 7 to 14 days. So if within these days there is a growth of that microorganism takes place, so that indicates that sputum sample consists of the pathogen, and that means that person from where that sputum sample is taken, that person is infected with Mycobacterium tuberculosis or he is suffering from TB. Okay, so that is the diagnosis here. Then third technique for diagnosis is here, that is chest radiography or chest X-ray. Okay, so this is the chest of healthy patient here, this one, and this is the chest X-ray of the person who is suffering from tuberculosis. Okay, so what is the difference here? See, the difference you will look here, this one, this portion. So here there is no white part is here, but here this white portion is here, just like this. Just 1 minute, I will show it by annotating it. Okay, see here, see this portion here, here. Okay, so that here there is no white part is here. So that's why it is the chest X-ray of the healthy patient, and this one is the, so this portion, it is of the person who is suffering from the tuberculosis. Okay, so in this way, that radiography or chest X-ray can be used for the diagnosis of the whether that person is suffering from tuberculosis or not. The next one is the nucleic acid amplification, that is multiplication, okay, of this or replication of the nucleic acid, and that is very useful for the species identification. Then low sensitivity or high cost, that means it is highly sensitive. Then most useful for the rapid confirmation test, because the result which are obtained from this nucleic acid amplification, that can be obtained in short duration. And that's why it is most useful for the rapid confirmation of tuberculosis if in persons with acid fast bacilli positive sputum. Agar koi person acid fast bacilli uske sputum mein dikh rahe hai microscopic examination ke baad, to aise cases mein agar hame confirm karna hai ki that person is infected with tuberculosis, to yahan pe nucleic acid amplification test bahut useful hai. And utility or utilization of this test, so AFB.
Sir, ऐसे AFB, what's the full form of AFB?
Acid fast bacillus, यहाँ पे.
Acid fast bacillus, okay sir.
So that acid fast bacillus positive sputum, that means that sputum, it is positive for this acid fast bacilli, and bacilli in the sense here, that Mycobacterium tuberculosis, okay? So this acid fast bacillus negative pulmonary tuberculosis can be diagnosed here. And extra pulmonary tuberculosis also can be diagnosed by using this nucleic acid amplification. Then another test is here for diagnosis, that is nothing but the tuberculin test here. Okay, TST, tuberculin test. Okay, so that tuberculin test, that is so actually this is the allergic reaction, or once that person get infected, then at that time that person shows the allergy, and that test is called as the tuberculin infection test or tuberculin skin test. So what is the skin test here? So that injection of fluid into the skin for the lower arm, matlab yahan pe ye is tarah se injection diya jata hai in this way here, okay? And after 48 to 72 hours injection ke baad, so this is yahan pe bhi aapko dikhaya ki tense tuberculin veil, or after 48 to 72 hours that part where that injection is given, that is checked for any particular reaction or allergic reaction, and that diagnosis, that means whether that person is infected with tuberculosis bacteria or not, that is based on the size of the veil or that swelling here, like this here. This is the skin portion, epidermis, then tense tuberculin veil after injection, that is after 48 to 72 hours, okay? Then this is the lower portion or dermis. So that is nothing but the, and in this way, after injection and after 48 to 72 hours, that type of reaction will take place here. When, if that person is infected with Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Or yahan pe ye size bhi wahan pe measure ki jati hai iski. Okay? So agar is tarah se reaction wahan pe aati hai, allergic reaction, to iska matlab hai, that person is suffering from the tuberculosis, or he is infected with tuberculosis. So see, this is the tuberculin test interpretation. मतलब कैसे वहां पे किया जाता है. अगर diameter of induration, induration मतलब वो जो ये red portion यहाँ पे दिखाया था मैंने आपको screen पे, that is called as induration. And वो अगर 6 millimeter से less है, कम है, तो interpretation क्या रहेगा test का? Negative. Negative मतलब so that previously unvaccinated individuals, they can give the BCG, provided that there are no contraindications or contraindications. That means negative in the sense here, that person is not suffering from the infection here, or bacillus, not infected with bacillus. Agar wahi jo reaction wahan pe aati hai, if that area is 6 millimeter or greater than, but less than 15 millimeter,